Hello and welcome to In Depth. I'm Tina Jha. All of us know what antibiotics are. In fact, whenever we suffer from a severe infection, our medical practitioner prescribes these powerful medicines to help us fight the infection caused by bacteria. Also known as antimicrobial drugs, antibiotics have saved countless lives since 1928 when penicillin, the first antibiotic, was used by doctors. But over the years, the misuse and overuse of these drugs has contributed to a phenomenon known as antibiotic resistance. This resistance develops when potentially harmful bacteria change in a way that reduces or eliminates the effectiveness of antibiotics. The world is heading rapidly towards a post-antibiotic era in which common infections will once again kill people. As per a UN report, at least 7 lakh people die each year due to drug-resistant diseases currently. By the year 2050, this number could go up to 10 million. It sounds alarmist, but that's the harsh truth brought to the fore by the World Health Organization. The efficacy of the world's antibiotics is quickly decaying. The drugs we are using to treat infections are working less and less. In India too, a recent study states that 2 out of every 3 healthy Indians are resistant to 2 major types of antibiotics. Clearly, if we continue at this rate without intervention, we may find that there is not a single antibiotic left to treat any type of bacterial infection. Today in In-Depth, we try and understand in detail about drug resistance, why it has become a global health issue, and what are the ways in which we can prevent and control antimicrobial resistance. A recent study has thrown up some startling and worrying results. A study published by the Indian Council of Medical Research says that antibiotic-resistant organisms in the digestive tracts of 2 out of every 3 healthy persons in India are resistant to antibiotics, indicating a rapid spread of antibiotic resistance in the Indian population. More details on the latest study about ICMR in this report.
Antibiotics, the remarkable drugs capable of killing biological organisms in our body without harming us. But according to a recent study published by the Indian Council of Medical Research, there has been a rapid rise of antibiotic resistance in the Indian population. In fact, 2 out of every 3 healthy people in India have antibiotic-resistant organisms in their digestive tracts. The study was based on the analysis of stool samples of 207 individuals who had not taken any antibiotics for at least a month and did not suffer from any chronic illness. The study found that 139 individuals were resistant to one or more class of antibiotics. The maximum resistance was seen for cephalosporins, followed by fluoroquinolones, 2 commonly used antibiotics. Only 2% of the individuals were found to be multi-drug resistant.
Through ICMR funded study conducted at PGI Chandigarh, and it tells about existence of drug resistance in the bacteria which were found in the gut. They have done some 200 plus patient study, and in 139 they have found that the bacteria which are normal gut flora, we call it, those bacteria which are excreted normally, they have got resistance to 2 of the very important antibiotics. So that is what the drug resistance is. The 2 antibiotics which were studied are cephalosporins, and the second one is fluoroquinolones. So those 2 are very frequently used antibiotics. And it has been found in this study that the bacteria are very resistant to those antibiotics.
Doctors believe that the inappropriate and sometimes rampant use of antibiotics has transformed the healthy human intestinal gut flora into a reservoir of antibiotic-resistant organisms. At present, these organisms are resistant to low-end antibiotics, but if the misuse persists, these may become resistant to high-end antibiotics as well. There are as many bacteria in our body as the number of cells. They perform a host of functions to keep the body running, for example, processing the food we eat and modulating the immune system. The antibiotic-resistant bacteria aren't healthy, so they cannot perform these functions well. The presence of antibiotic resistance in healthy individuals was a cause for concern because this signaled that it would get more difficult to treat infections in the future. There are many ways by which individuals become antibiotic resistant. An overuse of antibiotics. For example, antibiotics are now considered essential to treat the smallest of diseases. A rampant use of antibiotics in livestock and poultry animals. Antibiotics used in animals to treat infections and growth promotion are often passed on to humans who consume their meat. And the improper disposal of residual antibiotics that enter the food chain. In fact, this resistance has now surged into a public health nightmare around the world. Annually, at least 7 lakh people die from drug-resistant diseases, and that number is expected to rise to 10 million deaths per year by 2050 if nothing is done. With inputs from Vipul Agrawal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Resistance to antibiotics is now recognized as a public health threat of an unprecedented scale. And India, unfortunately, is the world's largest consumer of antibiotics. Looking at the rampant misuse and overuse of antibiotics in the country, the government has come up with a national policy aimed at the containment of antimicrobial resistance.
India has emerged as the world's largest consumer of antibiotics, stoking an increased fear of antibiotic resistance. According to a new study tracking consumption patterns for these drugs, the consumption has surged the most between the year 2000 to 2015. Globally, total antibiotic consumption soared 65% during the time period studied. At the forefront was India with a 103% increase, China with 79%, and Pakistan with 65%. India's consumption reflected highest in low and middle income countries. The average amount of antibiotics consumed by 1,000 inhabitants in India every day also increased 63% during this period. Compared to this, the consumption rate per 1,000 inhabitants increased 39% globally.
As I just mentioned, as an individual, we have to change our behavior. Even if new antibiotics come into the picture, if we don't change our behavior, the resistance will keep on coming even to the newer antibiotics. And I would like to add in a point here that hardly any new antibiotic has come in the recent years. Whatever new antibiotics are being marketed in the country are basically changes in the molecule of the existing antibiotics. Secondly, the pharmacist has to be responsible for his behavior, and he should not give any medication without a prescription. And government also has to strengthen its regulatory policies so that everybody becomes liable for their actions.
Since antibiotics have contributed significantly to a broad rise in life expectancy, its misuse and overuse has been rampant across India. Antibiotics are used for everything from preventing infections during surgeries to protecting cancer patients undergoing chemotherapy. Even as the weakening defenses leave a ripple effect on the entire healthcare chain. Recently, the United Nations has begun considering the threat of antimicrobial resistance to be at par with diseases like Ebola and HIV. Antibiotic resistance is a worldwide problem, but experts fear that India's excessive antibiotic usage is now leading to a powerful, never-before-seen mutation within bacteria.
On the sale of antibiotics. The sale of antibiotics should be only on the prescription which is by a qualified doctor. Unless you do that, this will not happen. The other thing is that I told about poultry farm. So there also antibiotics should not be given rampantly. To prevent infections, they give some antibiotics to those poultry farms. It should not be done. If you keep on doing that, antibiotic resistance will flourish like anything, and that will harm the human being.
With an alarming situation at the doorstep, India has come up with an action plan to tackle antimicrobial resistance.
A national policy for containment of AMR was introduced in 2011. The policy aims to understand emergence, spread and factors influencing AMR, to set up an antimicrobial program, to rationalize the use of antimicrobials, and to encourage the innovation of newer, effective antimicrobials. In addition, some major action points identified in the national policy were to establish an AMR surveillance system, to strengthen infection prevention and control measures, and educate, train, and motivate all stakeholders in the rational use of antimicrobials. Providing sanitation, clean water, and good governance, increasing public health expenditure, and better regulating the private health sector are all necessary steps to reduce antimicrobial resistance. With inputs from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Antibiotic resistance has the potential to affect people at any stage of life. So when a person is infected with an antibiotic resistant bacterium, not only is the treatment of that patient more difficult, but the antibiotic resistant bacterium may spread to other people as well. When antibiotics do not work, the result can be longer and more complicated diseases, the use of stronger and more expensive drugs, and gradually more deaths caused by bacterial infections. So to prevent antibiotic resistance, a number of initiatives have been taken at the global level, and various recommendations have been made by the World Health Organization. In our next report, let's look at some of the steps suggested by the world body.
Drug resistance happens when we overuse antibiotics in the treatment of humans, animals, as well as plants. When a new antibiotic is introduced, it can have great, even life-saving results, but only for some time. After that, the bacteria adapt. And gradually, the antibiotic becomes less effective, and we are left with a disease that we don't know how to treat. The World Health Organization says, antibiotic resistance is rising to dangerously high levels in all parts of the world. The world body recommends that countries must prioritize their national action plans to scale up financing and capacity building efforts, put in place stronger regulatory systems, and support awareness programs for responsible and prudent use of antimicrobials by professionals in humans, animals, and plant health. In addition, they must also invest in ambitious research and development for new technologies to combat antimicrobial resistance.
Antibiotic resistance is not a resistance of a human body or animal to the antibiotic, but it is a resistance which the bacteria or the infective organism develops towards the antibiotic. It is because of misuse of the drug, in appropriate use of the drug, inappropriate dosage, inappropriate duration, and inappropriate drug. The government is trying to take steps on it, but first of all, it is our behavior which has to change. Our behavior in the sense, like whenever we have a common cold or something, we go over the counter to the pharmacist, he gives us some antibiotics, we use it. We may be using the wrong antibiotic, wrong dosage, wrong duration, which leads to development of this antibiotic. So unless first of all, we have to change our behavior, that we don't do self-medication and we always take an advice of a qualified doctor to take the appropriate medication in the appropriate doses. Secondly, the government has to do strengthen this already existing regulatory mechanism. It's like the pharmacists in our country, if you will notice, that they will give you medication even without a prescription. So this is one of the biggest reasons, that misuse of medication by both the individual and the pharmacy.
The World Health Organization also suggests a number of steps that can be taken at various levels to reduce the impact and also limit the spread of this resistance. For individuals, the most important step towards preventing and controlling the spread of antibiotic resistance is to use antibiotics only when prescribed by a certified health professional. You should never demand antibiotics if your health worker says you do not need them. Always follow your health worker's advice when using antibiotics. Never share or use leftover antibiotics. Prevent infections by regularly washing hands, preparing food hygienically, avoiding close contact with sick people, practicing safer sex, and keeping vaccinations up to date.
prepare food hygienically. Follow the WHO 5 keys to safer food. That is to keep clean, separate raw and cooked, cook thoroughly, keep food at safe temperatures, use safe water and raw materials, and choose foods that have been produced without the use of antibiotics for growth promotion or disease prevention in healthy animals. Policymakers must also ensure that a robust national action plan is in place to tackle antibiotic resistance. Surveillance of antibiotic-resistant infections must be improved. Policies, programs, and implementation of infection prevention and control measures must be strengthened. It is required to regulate and promote the appropriate use and disposal of quality medicines. Information must also be made available on the impact of antibiotic resistance. Health professionals need to play a major role in preventing and controlling the spread of antibiotic resistance. The first and the foremost thing that must be done is to ensure that their hands, instruments and environment are clean. They should only prescribe and dispense antibiotics when they are needed. They must immediately report antibiotic-resistant infections to surveillance teams. They must talk to patients about how to take antibiotics correctly, antibiotic resistance and the dangers of their misuse. Other sectors like healthcare and agriculture must also act to prevent and control the spread of antibiotic resistance. The healthcare industry can invest in research and development of new antibiotics, vaccines, diagnostics and other tools. While the agriculture sector must adhere to the guidelines such as giving antibiotics to animals only under veterinary supervision. Antibiotics should not be used for growth promotion or to prevent diseases in healthy animals. Animals must be vaccinated to reduce the need for antibiotics and use alternatives to antibiotics when available. The agriculture sector should also promote and apply good practices at all steps of production and processing of foods from animal and plant sources. In addition, they must also improve biosecurity on farms and prevent infections through improved hygiene and animal welfare.
There is drug resistance. We have to know the causes of drug resistance. The most important cause is the frequent misuse and frequent use of antibiotics. You must have noticed that people, when fall ill, they have some throat infection or they have some upper respiratory infection, they immediately take antibiotics and they think that they will be cured very fast. The thing is that once you use frequently, what happens, the bacteria which are commonly found, they commonly found in your flora, they become very resistant to these bacteria. And if you keep on using only those antibiotics frequently, then what happens, they will become very, very resistant, they won't be treated at all. So that is the drug resistance, when you are providing antibiotics and antibiotic is not working, you are not seeing the effect. Means the bacteria which are present are resistant to the drugs being used, and that is the drug resistance. You know that in poultry farms also, people are using antibiotics. So those antibiotics, the chicken and other things, they also become antibiotic resistant. The people are eating, and then after that, the flora of antibiotic flora, the bacterial flora inside the human being, that also changes. So that is coming through ecosystem also.
Antimicrobial resistance is not a problem that can be solved by any one country or even one region. Since we live in a connected world where people, animals and food travel and microbes travel with them, a global action is essential to make progress in the long run. Raising public awareness and understanding is therefore the most crucial pillar towards tackling antimicrobial resistance. With inputs from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
The widespread use of antibiotics over the last couple of decades has dramatically reduced illness and death due to infectious diseases. But their indiscriminate use has come at the huge cost of antimicrobial resistance, or AMR, in the human body. The alarming rate at which bacteria are becoming resistant has led the World Health Organization to identify AMR as one of the top 10 threats to global health. More details in our next report.
In its latest report published in January this year, the World Health Organization terms antibiotic resistance as one of the biggest threats to global health, food security and development. The term antibiotic resistance or drug resistance is a subset of antimicrobial resistance or AMR, which is the ability of a microbe to resist the effects of medication that once could successfully eliminate the microbe and treat the disease. As per UN estimates, close to 7 lakh people die every year worldwide due to AMR. This rise in antibiotic resistance could kill 10 million people every year by 2050, which is more than those caused by cancers and road accidents combined. By 2030, antimicrobial resistance could force up to 24 million people into extreme poverty. The other threats in the WHO's list include HIV, Ebola, dengue, vaccine hesitancy, air pollution and climate change.
It has already been recognized that antibiotic resistance is a top threat, not only in India, it is globally a top threat, and it doesn't discriminate between any age group, races, whether it is in towns, villages, across the world, in every part of the country, we are facing it too.
Antimicrobial resistant microbes occur naturally and are found in people, animals, food, water, soil and air. They can spread between people and animals, including from the food of animal origin and from person to person. Antimicrobial resistance is facilitated by the inappropriate use of medicines, for example using antibiotics for viral infections such as the flu. Inadequately treated sewage waste containing resistant bacteria which mixes in the environment also magnify the burden of AMR. Poor infection control, inadequate sanitary conditions and inappropriate food handling encourage the spread of antimicrobial resistance. This is not the first time the WHO has raised an alarm over antibiotic resistance. AMR is an increasingly serious threat to global public health that requires action across all government sectors and societies. The need for a global surveillance system on AMR was highlighted by the organization in 2014. A year later, WHO launched the Global Antimicrobial Surveillance System, or GLASS, to work closely with WHO collaborating centers and existing antimicrobial resistance surveillance networks. As members of GLASS, countries are encouraged to implement the surveillance standards and indicators gradually based on their national priorities and available resources.
This year only it has come as a study that the drug resistance has been labeled as one of the top threats, and it has been put in parallel to the HIV and other top threats. So that is why it's a very, such a threat which is very harmful. Like if there are bacteria which are resistant, then some person gets infected with that bacteria, you won't be able to treat.
The spread of antibiotic resistance worldwide is undermining decades of progress in fighting bacterial infections. A recent example to take into account is the emergence of the drug-resistant tuberculosis. According to WHO, in 2017, around 6 lakh TB cases globally were resistant to the most effective first-line drug, and 82% of these people had multi-drug-resistant tuberculosis. New resistance mechanisms are emerging and spreading globally, threatening the ability to treat common infectious diseases, resulting in prolonged illness, disability, and even death. With inputs from Vipul Agrawal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
So that's it from us in today's edition of In Depth. We'll be back same time tomorrow with a focus on some other important subject. You can also watch our program online on YouTube and Twitter and send us your feedback and suggestions about our program. Thank you for your time.